在联邦卫生官员对英国瑞典制药商阿斯利康刚刚公布的疫苗实验结果提出罕见的质疑之后，白宫首席医疗顾问福奇3月24日表示，这意味着阿斯利康可能会发布一份更正后的声明。周一，该公司宣布了与牛津大学合作研发的新冠疫苗三期临床实验结果，称该疫苗整体有效性为 79%， 可100%预防重症和住院。第二天，国家过敏和传染病研究所发布了一份不同寻常的声明，称其接到的数据和安全监测委员会通知指出，阿斯利康疫苗可能依赖于过期的信息，并且可能提供了一个对疗效数据不完整的评估。福奇表示，安全监测委员会向其表达了担忧，认为阿斯利康公布的疫苗有效性数据比近期的实验结果对其更有利。
Which said that we urge strongly that AZ get back to the Data and Safety Monitoring Board to make sure that the data that is made public is accurately reflecting of what the actual data was. So that's the entire story. Right now, AZ is getting back.With the Data and Safety Monitoring Board, and will likely come out with a modified statement. We are always concerned when there is an apparent miscommunication, if you want to use that word, that would add to an already existing level of vaccine hesitancy. And that's the reason why, as Andy said, we want to make sure we're always completely transparent in everything that goes on with regard to our messaging.In vaccine. At the end of the day, you know, when you look at the data, this is going to be turn out to be a good vaccine. As Andy said, the final determination of the analysis of the data will be done by the FDA. When that is done, that is going to be very transparent as they meet with their VRBPAC, their advisory committee. So at the end of the day, everything is going to be open and transparent, and hopefully that will dispel.Any hesitancy that was associated with this little bump in the road that we happen to have most recently with AZ.
另外，有卫生专家表示，阿斯利康的数据问题只是该公司一系列错误中的最新一例，这些错误可能会影响人们接种这种疫苗的意愿。此前，人们对这种疫苗的有效性产生质疑，部分患者在接种疫苗之后出现了严重的血栓问题。欧洲药品监管机构在审查后认定，阿斯利康疫苗仍然安全有效。